Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. We were doing value at risk problems in my previous class. Let's start with the second problem. A portfolio consists of 4 lakh invested in shares of company A and rupees 6 lakh invested in shares of company B. The daily volatilities measured by standard deviation of these two stocks are 1% and 2% respectively. The stock returns are normally distributed. They are given the correlation as 0.40 and they are asking you to compute 10 days 99% value at risk of the portfolio. By what amount has the diversification reduced value at risk? Use model building approach. Model building approach or variance covariance approach is nothing but the method that I am solving. First sum that we did, that is itself the model building approach. So first what we do, we'll do it for value at risk for company A. So we have to find the chance of loss or volatility. To do this, what we do, we'll see what is the investment. The investment in company A is 4 lakh. So 4 lakh into the volatility of company A is 1%, because we've said it's 1% and 2% respectively, means for A it is 1%, for B it is 2%. So 1% of 4 lakh will be the chance of loss or volatility. So 1% of 4 lakh, you get it as 4,000. Now they have told 99% confidence level. 99% confidence level means the chance of loss is only that 1%. So we have to check that 1% in the table, and that in the table value it comes to 2.33. So we see the normal distribution table for 1% and we get it as 2.33. We'll write down that. Now we can find value at risk for 1 day, which is nothing but the chance of loss into the table value. So 4000 into minus 2.33, it will give me the value at risk for 1 day, which is minus 9320. Now this is for 1 day. They have asked us to do it for 10 days. So value at risk for 10 days is equal to minus 9320 into square root of 10 days. So now square root of 10 days, we will take more than 2 digits after the decimal so that we get a little closer answer, at least 4 digits. From 3.1622 we will take. So it will be value at risk for 10 days is equal to minus 9320 into 3.1622. If you want, you can take all digits also. So value at risk for 10 days see how much you get after multiplication.
29,472.42.
Minus 29,472.4. So this is the value at risk for company A for 10 days. Now we'll find similarly value at risk for company B. So again, we have to find the chance of loss. So chance of loss or volatility is equals to The investment in company B is 6 lakh. So 6 lakh into the volatility for company B is given here as 2%. So we take this 2%. So 2% of 6 lakh, the chance of loss is 12,000. Then 99% confidence level they have said. So at 99% confidence level, the table value is minus 2.33. So value at risk for one day is equals to 12,000. That is the chance of loss into the table value, which is minus 2.33. When you multiply, you get minus 27,960. So we'll find value at risk for 10 days, which is equal to minus 27,960 into square root of 10. So value at risk for 10 days. To see what is the final answer. Yes, ma'am. So this is value at risk for 10 days for company B. Now we will find it for the portfolio. Just look at the question. They have told you to compute 10 day value at risk for the portfolio, but we have also done the single ones, because here they have told by what amount has the diversification reduced value at risk. To find this, this is additional question. It was not there in the last problem. So to find the diversification benefit, we need single stock value at risk also and portfolio value at risk also. So I found out single. Now we will do it for the portfolio. So to do it for the portfolio, yesterday I had given you the formula. I'll just copy down that formula. Value at risk for portfolio is equals to standard deviation of A plus B. The two stocks here are A plus B, which is equal to square root of standard deviation of A square plus standard deviation of B square plus 2 into R into standard deviation of A into standard deviation of B. Not plus, this is into standard deviation of B. Now standard deviation is nothing but the volatility or the chance of loss which we found out for individual stock. For A 4000 and for B 12000. So that is standard deviation value. The standard deviation of A plus B is equal to square root of standard deviation of A square, so it is 4000 square plus standard deviation of B square, which is 12000 square plus 2 into standard R, that is correlation 0.4 into standard deviation of A, which is 4000, into standard deviation of B, which is 12,000. So this is square. I'll just take it up. So just find out the square values. See how much you're getting. This is the standard deviation of A plus B. is equal to square root of anybody has found out 4000 square, how much is it?
Sixteen lakh.
That's 12,000 square. 16 lakhs or?
I'm 1 crore 60 lakhs.
Yeah, that's what, 4,000 square. Six zeros, no? So 1 crore 60 lakhs. Plus we have to do 12,000 square.
And 14 crores 40 lakhs.
14 crores 40 lakhs. 14 crores. 144 and 6 zeros you should get. Plus 2 into, we'll do that entire multiplication. 2 into 0.4 into 4000 into 12,000. Three crore 84 lakhs. It is 384 and 5 zeros. So we will add all this and find its square root. So 384 plus 144. So if we add and find the square root of it, we get 14,085.45. All of you are getting it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Standard deviation of A plus B, that is it equals to 14,085.45. Now this is the chance of loss, or this is the volatility entry for the portfolio. If we have to find value at risk for the portfolio, we'll do value at risk is equals to the chance of loss, which is 14,085.45 into the table value for one percentile, which is -2.33. So we'll get value at risk for one day, which is equal to, after multiplying, I think you get -32,819. Just check.
Yes, ma'am.
-32,819. Anything after decimal you're getting?
10.
0.10. So this is value at risk for one day. Now we want value at risk for 10 days. So to find the value at risk for 10 days, we'll do -32,819.10 into square root of 10 days. Square root of 10 days value we found out, which was 3.1622. So we'll multiply, see what is the answer. Anybody has multiplied? Minus
3,780.
How much?
1,03,780.5.
Minus 1,03,780.5. So this is value at risk for 10 days for the portfolio. Now they have asked you to find the diversification benefit. How to find the diversification benefit? It is nothing but value at risk for A plus value at risk for B. So we are going to add the value at risk values of the individual stock, and from this we will minus value at risk for portfolio. If we do this, we'll get the diversification benefit. Okay, so we'll see what was the value at risk for A. It was minus 29,472 plus value at risk for B minus 88,415.11. We have to add both. Don't look at the sign. We need to add both the losses minus value at risk of the portfolio. So that is 14. Sorry, minus 1,03,780. I'm repeating it again here that minus sign is not important. Even if you don't take it, it's okay because you will get confused. So I'm removing that minus sign. Because anyways, all the three are negative and all the three are loss. So you add both, that is 29,472.42 plus 88,415.11. You get 1,17,887.53. From this you minus 1,03,780.5. So you get the diversification benefit. 14,107.03. All of you getting this?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is what is you save. That means this much less loss you have if you invest in a portfolio. So diversification benefit means instead of investing in individual security, if you combine both and invest in the portfolio, your loss is lesser. Individually, if I have the loss is 1,17,887. But if I combine both and invest as a portfolio, then my loss is only 1,03,780. So 14,107 is what I will save if I invest in both the stocks. But if I invest individually, my losses will be higher. So that was the second problem. I hope there was no doubt. Let's move to the third one. Anybody had any doubts here? Let's go to the third problem. A portfolio consists of rupees 40 lakh invested in company A and rupees 60 lakh in company B. Just a second. If you look at this problem now, it is same like the previous, the above one. Just look, the difference is here it was 4 lakh and 6 lakh, whereas same 1%, 2% volatility, 0.4 correlation, 10 days, 99%. Just look here. Instead of 4 lakh, 6 lakh, what they have done is they just made it 40 lakh, 60 lakh. Again, there is A and B company. 1%, 2% is the volatility. 0.4 is the correlation. They wanted to find 10 day at 99% confidence level. So it is exactly same. Instead of 4 lakh, 6 lakh, they just made it 40 lakh, 60 lakh. So 110 has been increased. Will you try it at home or you want me to do it again everything?
We will try it, ma'am.
We'll do it, ma'am.
Okay. Instead of getting answers in thousands, now you will get it in lakhs. So if you had got 88,417, now you will get 8,84,172, like that. So you try this sum, just instead of thousands, it will come in lakhs. So I'll do with the fourth sum. I'll share this document with you so that you can try that sum. Okay. The fourth sum says, in the previous 45 trading days, the daily volatility of 1.25% is observed for an investment of rupees 5 lakh in the shares of ABC Limited. At 98% confidence level, calculate value at risk for a period of 1 month, assuming 25 trading days in a month. So here they have told only for a single stock. There is no portfolio, so we need not do for a portfolio. Only for ABC Limited, we have to find the justification and this method of. Only for ABC Limited, we have to find the value at risk. So let us start. Value at risk for ABC Limited. So first we do chance of loss or volatility, which is equal to the investment in the stock is 5 lakh into, they have told that the volatility is 1.25% is observed. So 1.25 divided by 100, we get 6,250. So this is the chance of loss or volatility. Now we have to find the, they have told us to do it at 98% confidence level. So at 98% confidence level, we'll have to find the table value. Yes. At 98% confidence level, 98 minus 100, so it is 2 percentile. So we have to find 2% value, which is nothing but 0.02 in the table, and that comes to, in the initial I have given you those values, 98% it is -2.06. So we'll take that value as -2.06. So this is the table value at 98% confidence level. Then we'll find the value at risk for 1 day, which is equal to the chance of loss 6,250 into the table value, that is -2.06. When we multiply, value at risk for 1 day is equal to -12,875. Then value at risk for 10 days, they want you to do it for 25 days. See here, they have told you calculate value at risk for 1 month. So in 1 month, in the bracket, they have asked you to assume 25 trading days. So we are not going to take full 30 days of the month. They have asked that 25 days is the trading. So assume 25 days. So we are doing value at risk for 25 days. We need to always convert it into days. We cannot do it for months and years. So if they give 1 month, 30 days in a month we can take. If they mention less than that, then you take 25 days like it is mentioned here. If they tell 6 months, we'll do 6 months into 30 days. Whatever number of days we get, accordingly we will take. So now to find value at risk for 25 days, you have to do -12,875 into square root of 25 days. square root of 25 is. Value at risk for 25 days is equal to, let's see how much you get.
64,375.
Square root of 25 is 5. So minus 12,875 into 5, you get it as minus 64,375. So ABC Limited will lose 64,375 rupees in 25 days if the volatility is 1.25%. Okay, so that was the fourth problem. Let's do the fifth one. Consider an investor has 10 million portfolio of bonds in a long position. Suppose the confidence level is 95%. Actual daily standard deviation of the portfolio is 3.67%. What is the daily value at risk for the portfolio? What is the value at risk for a 1 month time horizon, that is 30 days? So here they are asking you to find the risk for the portfolio. Now, if I have to use the formula of the portfolio, I should have multiple number of shares. So if you remember, the formula is standard deviation of A plus B, which is equal to square root of standard deviation of A square plus standard deviation of B square, and so on. So here I don't have A plus B. I mean, I don't know how many shares are there in the portfolio. So I cannot use that formula because individual stock values are not given. So I'll use the normal formula only and find the value at risk for the portfolio. So what is the normal way to do it? We just find the chance of loss. So chance of loss is equal to, the investment is $10 million. 10 million is equal to, 1 million is 10 lakh. So 10 million is equal to 100 lakh, which is nothing but 1 crore, correct? All of you are there with me. 10 million is equal to 1 crore because 1 million is equal to 10 lakh. So 10 million will be 100 lakhs. 100 lakhs is nothing but 1 crore into the chance of loss. 3.67% they're saying. So 3.67 is the volatility. So 3.67% of 1 crore is 367,000. So this is the chance of loss of the portfolio. Now we'll find the table value at, just a second. We'll find the table value for 95% confidence level. So we'll write the 95 minus 100, that is the fifth percentile value we want. Just mention it here. 95% confidence level. So 95 minus 100. It is the fifth percentile. So 0.05. If we see minus 0.05 in the table value, we get it. The value is 1.65, minus 1.65. We'll take that value. Minus 1.65. So if I solve it, we get value at risk for 1 day is equal to 367,000, the chance of loss, into minus 1.65, the table value. The value at risk for 1 day will be 5,550. This is the value at risk for 1 day. we wanted for 1 month, and they have told clearly 30 days are there in the month. So we want value at risk 30 days is equal to minus 6,05,550 into square root of 10, sorry, square root of 30 now. So we'll see the square root of 30 value, how much we get. Square root of 30. So 5.4772 is what we get if I take 4 digits after the decimal. So value at risk for 30 days is equals to minus 6,05,550 into 5.4772. So multiply and see how much you get.
33,16,718.
So value at risk for 30 days is equals to 33,16,718.46 minus. So this is what is the loss on the portfolio. Even if they have given the portfolio word, I have not used the portfolio formula because I made single security values if I am doing it the portfolio way. It was not given, so we did it this way. Let's do the next one. Consider a position consisting of rupees 1 lakh investment in asset A and rupees 1 lakh in asset B. Assume that the daily volatilities of both the assets are 1%, so both are going to change by 1%, and that the coefficient of correlation between their returns is 30%. 30% means if I do 30 divided by 100, I'll get it as 0.3. Okay. What is the 5-day 99% value at risk for the portfolio? Also calculate the diversified risk benefit. So let's do it for A first. Value at risk for A. So first step is chance of loss, which is equal to the investment in A, 1 lakh into 1% is the volatility. So 1 divided by 100 of 1 lakh, 1% is 1000. Now we have to find that 99% confidence level value. So 99% confidence level, the value is minus 2.33. 99% means 1 percentile. Minus 2.33. So we'll have value at risk for 1 day is equal to 1000 into minus 2.33, which will get it as minus 2330. This is value at risk for 1 day for A. We want it for 10 days. Is equals to minus 2330 into square root of 10 days. Can anybody tell me the answer? Thank you.
7368.10.
7368.10 is the value at risk that we get. They've asked for 10, oh sorry, they've asked for 5 days. Just look at this. I thought it is 10 days. They've just asked for 5 days. So it will change again. I'm sorry, I took 10 days. See how much it is for 5 days.
$5,210.00.
Similarly, we'll do value at risk for B. So value at risk for B. Again, the same chance of loss is 1,01% because we are investing the same in B. So 1% of 1,00,000 is 1,000. Similarly, the table value at 99% confidence level is -2.33. Then value at risk for 1 day is 1000 into -2.33, which is 2330. And similarly, we have to find the 5 days value, which will be exactly same. The answer doesn't differ because both the stocks are investing 1,00,000. Both the stocks have the same loss and both the stocks have the same confidence level. So -5,210 as it is if we solve for it. Now we have to find value at risk for the portfolio. So the formula, I'll just take it from above. Standard deviation of A plus B is equals to square root of chance of loss of A was 1000, so 1000 square plus for B also it was 1000 because 1% is the volatility on 1,00,000 in plus 2 into what was the correlation given. I think it was given at 30%. So 30% means 0.3. 30 divided by 100 if we do. So 2 into correlation is 0.3 into 1000, which is standard deviation of A, and 1000, which is standard deviation of B. So if we solve for this, I'll directly give you the answer which I have got. You can check it later once afterwards when you solve for it. Okay, so I have got 1612.45. If anybody has done it and got the same answer, please confirm. Otherwise, you can cross-check it later. That was the chance of loss or volatility for the portfolio. Now we need value at risk for 1 day, which is nothing but that chance of loss, 1612.45. into the table value -2.33. Value at risk for 1 day is equal to -3757.002. It is, if you want, you can take or you can just keep it like that, 3757. Now value at risk for 5 days is equal to -3757.002 into square root of 5 days. So if I do into square root of 5 days, value at risk for 5 days will be 8,400.90 is what I have got. This is the value at risk for 5 days for the portfolio. Now we'll find the diversification benefit. Diversification benefit is value at risk for A plus value at risk for B minus the portfolio value. So value at risk for A was 5,210 plus 5,210.03. Same was for B, 5,210.03. From this minus the portfolio value at risk 8,400.90. So if I solve this, the benefit that we will get is minus 2019.13. If you take all the minus sign. So this is the loss that will reduce. This is what we are going to save if we invest in both the stocks as a portfolio. But if you invest individually, you will lose 5,000 and 5,000. But whereas in the portfolio, you are losing 8,400 in total. Any doubts with this sum? Last sum, we'll finish it and we'll wind up the fifth unit today so that Friday I can start with the third unit. Now this sum is a little different, so listen carefully. It's not tough, it's just a little different from the normal one. Calculate the portfolio value at risk using variance covariance method from the following portfolio. So they have given you security 1, long 100 shares of ATC Limited, price of the share is 35.16 and there is 1 year volatility 18%. Security 2 is in SBI, price 1 year volatility 16%, correlation is 0.4, and they have also told you to calculate the diversified risk. Can anybody tell me what is missing here?
Ma'am, investment value.
What is missing?
Investment value, ma'am. We have to multiply the number of shares into the price given.
Yeah, that we have to do to get the value. That is 100 shares into 35.16. I'll get the total value of the investment. So that we'll find. Anything else is missing?
Confidence level.
Correct. Confidence level is missing. And we cannot assume it. That's why they have also asked you to use the variance covariance method. Variance covariance method is a little different from model building approach. Here the confidence level will not be given. So whatever is our chance of loss, that only is the final loss. We don't have to multiply it with the table value again, because the table value, we don't have it only. So in case of variance covariance approach, the method will be same. Only the table value we won't have, because they will not give you the confidence level and you cannot assume it. So only find the chance of loss, that itself will be value at risk for 1 day. Is that okay, all of you? Or it is actually value at risk for 1 year, because they have given you 1 year volatility, whereas in the above problems they gave you 1 day volatility. So let us start finding it. So value at risk for security 1. So I'll find the chance of loss. How to find the chance of loss? You have to do investment into volatility. So investment is 100 shares into the price per share, which is rupees 35.16. So if I multiply this, I'll get the investment into, I have to do the volatility. Volatility for 1 year is 18%. So 18 divided by 100. So I will get the chance of loss as 640.98. So this is the value at risk for stock 1. Instead of chance of loss, you can write here value at risk, because we don't have the table value, the confidence level. The next step, what we do was we do this chance of loss into the table value to get the value at risk. But here there is no confidence level, so this itself is the value at risk according to variance covariance approach. Similarly, we'll do it for security 2. Chance of loss is equal to SBI, there are 50 shares into the price 71.15 into the volatility 16%, so 16 divided by 100. So value at risk for SBI, if we multiply, it is 569.2. Now they have asked to find for portfolio value at risk for security 1 plus security 2, which is nothing but we take it as standard deviation of security 1, security 2. So the same formula. So standard deviation of security A and B, instead of that there is security 1 and 2. The standard deviation of security 1 square, the standard deviation of security 2 square, 2 into R into standard deviation of 1 into standard deviation of 2. So here 1 plus 2.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, value at risk for security 1 is coming
632.88. 632.88?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And for security B, is it correct?
Yes, ma'am, it is correct.
Okay. So we'll find security 1 square, that is 632.88 square plus 569.2 square plus 2 into, they have given the correlation here is 0.4 into security 1 loss 632.88 into security 2 standard deviation or loss, that is 569.2. So if you solve this, we will get the answer of value at risk for the portfolio. Just solve and check the answer, because I have taken 640 and solved and got a different answer. So this you can complete it as homework. You find the answer and let me know what is the value at risk. And then last, they have asked you the diversification benefits, for which this is the formula. So diversification benefit, also you know now value at risk for A and B, minus just find the portfolio and find the value. I'll also complete it and give you this particular document. You also try and see what is the answer. If anybody has any doubts, you can ask. Otherwise, we can wind up with the class. One last note I have to tell you. Sometimes they give you variance value instead of standard deviation. Instead of standard deviation or volatility. Volatility is nothing but standard deviation. Okay, so 1%, 2% volatility, it's nothing but the standard deviation. So you need to convert variance into standard deviation. How do you convert variance into standard deviation, anybody?
Root, ma'am.
X square root.
The formula is, you know, standard deviation is equals to variance square. Remember? Sorry. I think standard deviation is equals to square root of variance, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So that is what is the formula you need to use. Find the square root of whatever is given. So I'll just write there, square root of variance. I'll give an example. Example, suppose they give variance is equal to 49. Then what will be the standard deviation, anybody?
7.
7. We have to do square root of 49, which is 7. So that is how you will have to convert it to, so it is square root of 49. Therefore, standard deviation is equal to square root of 49, which is equal to 7. So that means the volatility is 7%. In one of the sums, they had given like that. I'm not finding that question, others would have solved it. Everything else is same. Instead of giving you standard deviation, they have given variance is 49. So you need to find the square root of 49. You will get the standard deviation, which is 7, or you can also write it as 7%, because volatility basically comes in percentage. Is that clear? If it comes, you need to do it like this. Everybody, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we'll wind up the class for today. If you have any doubts, you can ask. Otherwise, you can type the roll numbers, USN numbers, and leave the meeting. I'll share this document with you in some time.